using Narcan nasal spray for a known or suspected heroin opioid overdose. What causes an overdose? Too much of an opioid overwhelms the part of the brain that drives breathing. As a result, breathing can become slow or may even stop. How does Narcan work? Narcan blocks or reverses the effects of opioid medications. In most cases, the effect is immediate, within 30 to 40 seconds. Narcan has no potential for abuse and will have no effect if accidentally administered or self-administered, as in the case of a child. The brain has many receptors for naturally occurring opioids. An overdose occurs when too much of an opioid, like heroin, OxyContin, or Percocet, fits in too many of these receptors, stopping the person's breathing. Narcan bonds more strongly to the opioid receptors than opioid drugs, so it effectively knocks the opioids off the receptors for a short time. This blocks the effects of the overdose, allowing the person to breathe again. Always call 911. Narcan does not replace professional medical attention. Call 911 after administering Narcan. Narcan is the only effective response to an opioid overdose emergency. Narcan is effective against opioids such as heroin, methadone, OxyContin, Vicodin, Percocet, codeine, or fentanyl. Narcan will not reverse an overdose from drugs such as cocaine, meth, methamphetamine, alcohol, stimulants, or benzos, benzodiazepine, such as Xanax and Valium. Myths about how to reverse an opioid overdose. Do not put them in a bath. They could drown. Do not induce vomiting or give them something to drink. They could choke. Do not try to stimulate them in a way that could cause harm, such as slapping or punching. Do not inject them with foreign substances like salt water, milk, or other drugs. It will not help reverse the overdose and may expose them to bacterial or viral infections. Any of the following are signs of an opioid overdose. The person's face is clammy to the touch and has lost color. The person has difficulty speaking. The center part of their eye is very small, sometimes called pinpoint pupils. The person's body is limp. Their fingernails or lips have a blue or purple tinge. Sleep is deep, and the person cannot be woken. They will not respond to your voice or touch. Their breathing is slow or has stopped. Their heartbeat is slow or has stopped. What to do for an overdose? 1. Identify overdose. If any of these signs are present, continue to step 2. Failure to respond when spoken to. Failure to wake up when prompted. Slow or no breathing. Tiny pupils, the center part of the eye. 2. Administer a dose of Narcan nasal spray. Each sprayer contains 1 dose. Turn them on their back. Tilt their head back. Support their neck with your hand. Insert the tip of the nozzle into either nostril. Press the plunger firmly to deliver the dose. 3. Call 911 for help and continue to evaluate their condition. Roll them on their side in this position. Watch closely for a response. Give them a second dose in the other nostril if they do not respond in 2 to 3 minutes by waking up, responding to voice or touch, or by breathing normally. Narcan can be given every 2 to 3 minutes if available. Always call 911. Narcan's effects last 30 to 45 minutes. The person may go back into overdose after the Narcan has worn off. What to expect after administering Narcan? In some cases, Narcan may cause sudden opioid withdrawal syndrome, so it is important to be ready for symptoms of withdrawal, which may include vomiting, agitation, restlessness, diarrhea, or goosebumps. Storing Narcan. Narcan is a fairly stable medication with a shelf life of between 18 months and 2 years. Narcan should be stored at temperatures between 59 and 86 degrees Fahrenheit. Narcan should be kept from freezing. The nasal sprayer may not work if it has been subjected to freezing or colder temperatures. For more information, go to www.opioids.alaska.gov. To learn more about Project Hope, email projecthope@alaska.gov.